Okay. So, it's January 6th, 2018. It's currently about minus 31 with wind chill. It's warmed up a little bit. I got 4 hours of sleep last night. Was up to go to the barn at 4. Came back from the barn, did chores. Gonna head back to the barn in a little bit. Come back and do chores again. Both the brindle puppies are sleeping here. Honey's sleeping there. Yeah, and I got my seed order. I ordered it on the 2nd, I believe. So, like 3 days ago. It shipped yesterday. Perks of a local seed company is it gets here super fast. So I want to go through what I ordered, what came in the package, and some 2018 goals so that when I look back at this at the end of the year, I can see what I did and what I didn't do and what I learned from and how my, you know, camera skills have come along and what all I got done. My eye is twitching. That's what happens when you don't get enough sleep. That's one of my goals. Take better care of my body. I guess. So, some of the farm goals that me and Mama came up with. Plant 5 fruit trees. Finish building my pole barn. Hatch some turkey eggs from the turkeys that we raised. We've got 5 right now. 4 hens and a tom. So hopefully we'll have enough broody hens to set eggs under, because we can't do incubator with the solar power right now because it's not fixed yet. So I'm going to have to hatch all broody eggs, or all broody hens to hatch the eggs. But I'm excited about that. I want to put them in my empty rabbit hutches so they have their own space and their own nest and food and water and everything. I'm excited for chicks this year. I'm also going to order a bunch of meat birds. So, hatch turkey eggs, a big garden, milk the goats. Last year we didn't have kids. We had a problem with our buck and nobody got bred. And this year we got a new buck. So we're going to have a little Nubian alpines and they're going to have the little floppy ears. And I'm hoping Moonshine will have a doe we can keep. And then we're excited to make cheese and yogurt with the goat's milk. And maybe kefir or kefir, however. I want to shear the sheep. I want to see how that works and if it's possible, and we'll learn from it and then decide whether we're going to keep sheep or not, or whether I'm going to keep sheep. And hopefully the sheep are due sometime in the next 10 days. I'm hoping they'll wait till Monday at least, and it's above zero. We've had below zero for like a week now. So we want to raise a wether, a goat, for meat, probably for dog food, but we haven't done that since I was a baby, and we'd like to see if we can do that. Pigs were a big hassle last year, and it would be nice to raise some of our own meat. We don't quite have enough pasture for cows right now, but we do for goats, so we want to try and raise a wether. If my sheep do lamb, and if there are any ram lambs, I want to try and do mutton. And then we want to do compost fed meat birds. So we're going to get all the compost from the camp kitchen, which is usually 2 to 4 5-gallon bucketfuls a day. So hopefully that'll support or at least supplement a large majority of the meat birds' food. Okay, I'm going to check on my memory card storage space. Okay, should be good. I have a small memory card in, so I gotta check on that every now and then. Alright, so this is my package, and I think I've got my invoice here in the computer. So, there are 2 things that I got that did not ship because they're back-ordered and they'll ship in the next month or so. And that is Green Machine Zucchini, 10 seeds, and Echinacea, 1/32 of an ounce. And the total invoice for the things that did ship is $94.70. I got free shipping. I think it ended up being like $101.60-something or something for all the things I ordered, including the two that are backordered. So, I'm going to open up the package from High Mowing Seeds. So exciting. Alright. So we've got the invoice. Join the conversation. Hashtag why we grow. So I ordered from High Mowing this year because they're very local, and a lot of the seeds are grown here in Vermont or developed in Vermont, New Hampshire, or New York, or are a variety that does well here. So some of the larger packages of seeds, well, for example, my two Cascadia snap peas. I got two so I can do multiple plantings. They're not in the great shape for seed packets. They got sealed sloppy. But it doesn't matter. They're holding the seeds. They got the information on the back, which I haven't quite figured out when I'm going to plant. I'm going to try and start most of my own plants this year. Right. But doesn't matter. They're here. I'm excited for peas. I love peas. So two snap peas. Ring of Fire Cayenne Hot Pepper. This looked exciting. They had a limited variety, but we go through a lot of cayenne. I don't like spicy food, but we use it in all sorts of stuff. So I figured if we try and grow our own, even if we only get a few, it's a new experiment, and we can dry it and grind it and stuff. So this is an Ico Sweet Pepper, and I believe these were like purplish. But I was excited about them. I like sweet peppers better than spicy. So next is a Long Pie Pumpkin. And it's, this actually looked interesting. It's a pie pumpkin, but it grows like a squash. It's not round. It's like long, like a weird zucchini. I don't know. They look interesting. I'm hoping it'll be a little easier to process. And they're supposed to be very prolific. So a Sora Radish. I believe these are better for summer, for heat. I had trouble with radishes last year. I think I got two varieties of radish. I don't know, maybe the other ones. I tried to get two. I hope it's in here. So one in the summer, and then hopefully one later on. We got Sora Radish. Escalade F1 Spinach. So this is a summer spinach, and then I got winter Bloomsdale spinach, so hopefully I'll have two crops of this, two crops of spinach, so we can have a longer season there. Because I don't like spinach, but I like mixing it into things and adding it to, you know, egg recipes and all sorts of stuff, and it's a good... spinach is good for us, so we'll eat it. Smooth Operator F1, which I thought was the one that they... Oh, no, that's the Summer Squash. Okay. And then I got Green Machine. So, Smooth Operator F1, Summer Squash. Buttercup Winter Squash. We like Buttercup. Butternut squash. I like butternuts. Bush delicata squash. That's a good one too. I'm hoping we can use lots of squash. And I have a goal for this year to eat for a week off of things that we grew or raised or bartered or traded for or foraged or fished or hunted or whatever. So every meal for a week and every snack and everything in between will be something from this land or something that we sourced locally by trading rather than buying. Which is part of why I'm going for such a big garden. And Matt's wild cherry tomatoes. I don't think I've tried these ones before, but I love cherry tomatoes. Indigo apple tomato. These are a bigger one. They're not beefsteak big. They're like medium. I don't like the big, big ones. But these are cool. They're like purple and green striped. So I thought that would be interesting. We have the classic red, and then we're trying something new. Then Goldie ground cherries. I planted these last year and they didn't come up. And I really want to try again and see what happened because I had issues last year with the garden. So we're giving them another chance. Then we got Blacktail Mountain watermelon. We've never had good luck with watermelon, so I'm hoping starting it early and keeping the chickens off of it, because we can get it to grow, but if we keep the chickens off of it, maybe we'll have some watermelon this year, which would be awesome. And I think this is a relatively short 78 days to maturity, 76 days. So hopefully it'll be able to ripen in our season. And this is Alidia basil, 100 seeds. So I'm hoping to make pesto and what's the thing? It's like toast and tomato and basil and cheese. Or bread or whatever. I'm hoping to make that all from scratch. I'm not doing too many grains. I might try millet and black oil sunflower seeds again, but that's about it for grains. So I'd make the bread and then we can make mozzarella with the goat cheese. And I don't know. I'm excited for that. So, second package. This is a lot of seeds. I think I got myself in big. Alright, Blue Lake FM1 pole beans. Sarah, pole beans. I'm looking forward to dilly beans and salads and just having something that's always ripening. Boro F1 beets. I love pickled beets. I love beets. Bellstar F1 broccoli. We did broccoli once and, well, Mama did broccoli once and she froze it all. And then we refused to eat it. So, we'll have to eat this fresh. Starburst carrot blend. So this has like yellow and red and purplish carrots. And I'm noticing all these packets have interesting little label. I don't know if my camera will focus, it got cold earlier. But it says, packed for 2018, sell by 12/31/2018. Our seeds are tested twice a year to ensure quality. And pretty much all of them have had that, which I like. Because sometimes you get old seeds and they don't grow well. And these were kind of pricier seeds. So I'm glad they're newer. Rainbow blend chard. I did this last year. And this one says packed for 2018 too. Yeah, I did this one last year and it grew really well. It got big before I could eat all of it, and I didn't actually finish. There was tons left once we got our first frost. Actually, they were in the greenhouse, or hoop house, or whatever. It wasn't a full greenhouse. But they did really well, and I love chard, so. Red Express cabbage. We're going to try a cabbage. Usually it gets buggy. We'll see what happens. I hope to make my own sauerkraut with these. Make nice purple sauerkraut. Extra tender sweet corn. We'll see what happens. We don't have good luck with sweet corn, but I'm going to try my hardest. And then lemon cucumber. I did two types of cucumber last year. This was one of them. I was excited about it. They're kind of weird brown yellow cucumbers. 68 days to maturity. They look interesting. They did not come up last year, so I'm going to try and start them inside this year. And then National Pickling Cucumber. I love this one. None of my cucumbers came up last year. So hopefully we have better luck because I love cucumbers and I hope to make pickles. Dwarf Green Curled Kale. And I believe... Okay, I only got one variety of kale. High Yielding. Direct. So... Yeah. Kale. And then Yankee Hardy Blend Lettuce and Red Planet Salad Blend. So two salad mixes, one's earlier in the season, one's later. Which one's? So So this is spring and summer, and I believe this is more of fall. Hardy, yeah. Resistant and cold tolerant. And then last but not least, or last that's been shipped so far, is melon. PMR Delicious Melon. I've never grown melon. I've never tried to grow melon. I love melon. We'll see what happens. We're going to have a lot of squash and stuff this year. And then, like I said earlier, the echinacea and the zucchini are still waiting for those to ship. I actually have a zucchini still sitting on the table, and it's stayed really well. It's nice and big. From the garden last year from high mowing seeds. At least I think it was high mowing. Maybe it was something we got at the feed store. I don't know. And I'm hoping to save some of those seeds and replant because those stored really well and I don't remember the variety. But I also got more because they're great to feed to chickens and turkeys and make brownies and all sorts of stuff. So, yeah. Hashtag why we grow. We grow because in January it's minus 35 degrees and we can't go outside and we tell the dogs, just pee on the floor, I don't want to let you out, I don't want to open the door. I'm halfway joking. I can't decide if I'm joking on that or not. We grow because in the winter we forget about the bugs and the weeds and mosquitoes biting us. And we just want to put our hands in the dirt. So. Yeah, we'll see what happens. And I'll check in again, I guess. I'm hoping to do some video of our progress this summer of ordering meat birds and building the, you know, building the farm. I'm going to be working this summer. Bailey Farm and working here. His mom is going to be full-time at camp. I'm going to be busy, but hopefully happy busy. Got my dogs and hope to get back out to my tiny house soon as this weather cooperates and I can fix the heating and then all will be well. So, enjoy the ride. And good luck with this year.